Please stand and join in singing the Villanova alma mater. For the past 21 years, Don Giannella has been at the helm of the Villanova Pastoral Musicians, directing them as we add beauty and meaning to the liturgies here at Villanova, and creating a lasting legacy of students and alumni who will always treasure the memories of making music in this place.
And when we heard that he was laying down his baton and moving to a new position as Director of Transfer Admissions in the College of Arts and Sciences, all of his musicians, past and present, knew we needed to mark this occasion, lest Don or anyone else fail to understand the impact he has had on our lives, our music, our faith, and our ministry.
Tonight, we have a remarkable program for you filled with classic Villanova songs.
And sung by Villanova's own loyal heirs, we have come to Alma Mater to truly leave an echo ringing.
Although we'll end with an alleluia instead of a sweet amen.
So, without further ado, we invite you to enjoy Unitas Veritas Caritas.
Celebrating 21 years of Villanova pastoral music.
Thank you.
thinking of Unitas and how this mess manifests itself here at Villanova, I could not come up with a better example than that of the pastoral musicians. What better representation of unity is there than having over 200 busy musicians give up their time and talents to commemorate one person who has had such an enduring impact on the Villanova community for the last 21 years? When I think of pastorals, I think of family. People who come together to support each other and work together to support others each week at Mass. As an incoming freshman, still trying to find my place at Villanova, like most, this group gave me and all of the other new members the space to grow professionally, spiritually, and personally. In watching each of our alumni return, we see this joy and compassion for each other and for each member of the group has lasted long beyond graduation. Now, as the president of the group, I have the immense privilege and honor of helping to create that sense of unity for our incoming members, none of which would be possible without the direction of Don Giannella. One of my favorite things to hear when we sing is that moment when two voices so perfectly blend that we forget that two people are singing. We lose where one person starts and another begins. And reflecting with Don before the concert, we were worried about pulse because we have 200 musicians here. But everyone throughout the 21 years is united. Most songs you'll see do not have a conductor. That is unity. You may notice small smiles and glances between our many members gathered here today. This is our signification that we understand the unity. This concert was organized to demonstrate this impact in the pastoral musicians and to thank Don Giannella. Few people could pull together a group of this magnitude where alumni, the parish choir, and busy students volunteer their time to give thanks and give back to the community each week. I believe that the pastoral musicians find so much success due to the group's understanding in the Villanova mission and the role of music in the Catholic Church as a means to create a space for prayer and growth, as of the necessity of a strong community in accomplishing this task. On behalf of the current members of the group, I wish to express my gratitude and thanks to Don Giannella and wish him the best of luck in the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences. Thank you, Don.
Lord,
for Villanova. V for victory. V for Veritas. I joined Pastoral Musicians as a sophomore in the fall of 2002, and not too long after they held auditions to select the year's cantors. Luckily, when Don asked me to sight read, he gave me a song I already knew by heart. So, without realizing it, I auditioned for and found myself a member of the Pastoral Musicians Select Ensemble. I was terrified, mostly because I couldn't really sight read. A little also because Don was pretty terrifying. At the time, the Select Ensemble was known simply as SALS. It was short for Salvator Mundi, the name of the song we were working on. As most of us here know, Don is a champion at bestowing nicknames, so SALS we were. I liked it. It was an inside joke. It was also the most difficult piece of music I had ever sung up to that point in my life, as it should be, considering the complexity of the subject matter. Salvator Mundi, savior of the world. But the following year, Don changed the name of our little ragtag group of SALS. All of a sudden, we were Veritas. I assume he realized that you can't put SALS into a printed program, and Select Ensemble sounds a little onerous and a little too gauche. Veritas had some gravitas. I hated that name change at first. Why not Unitas? Why not Caritas? Why Veritas? And then, because I tend to overthink things, and because I was now spending 5 hours a week listening to Don wax eloquent, I finally worked it out. Veritas. It's truth. It spoke perfectly to the mission of the pastoral musicians. We have a very vocal part in liturgical ministry. Every time we open our mouths or pick up our instruments, we prepare to present the truth to anyone present to hear it. That's truth with a capital T, our truth, the truth of our faith, the truth of our lives, the veritas that we here at Villanova strive for in our courses, in our service, and in our worship. And Don made this clear in many ways from day one. We are not performers. This is not a stage. And we do not gather and practice and learn and challenge ourselves and dive into the exquisite compositions created by centuries of expert musicians, many of whom owed their livelihoods to the patronage of the Catholic Church. We don't do all this to show off or to sound pretty or to make people feel good. We sing because that is how we use our gifts to manifest the Word of God. There was a philosopher and theologian named John O'Donohue. He's Irish. He recently passed away, but he once said, "Words would love to be music, if only they could be." My assumption, my hope, is that you're here tonight because you know this as well. And what I truly loved about singing for Don, with Don, was that he explained the significance of the songs to us, the theology of the words, the philosophy of the music. He would touch on these things to give us context from which to build notes into epiphanies. The slow building of a chord, the effective dynamics of repetition, the impossible suspension, and then ineffable resolution. These music tactics are echoes of prayer life. And though I may have known that here in my heart, I don't believe I ever would have worked it out here in my head if it weren't for Don. And if that doesn't make sense to you in your head, well, if we're doing our job, it doesn't have to. If you were ever blessed enough to attend a Palm Sunday Mass here in this beautiful church between the years of 2003 and 2005, you would have been packed in like sardines, kind of like this, shoulder to shoulder, rolling through the Passion readings and hoping you pronounce Barabbas the same way that everyone else did. But then, when Jesus died on the cross, when he breathed his last, Kelly Fallon would stand and sing Pia Jesu. And when that happened, you didn't need to know Latin. You didn't need to be a fan of Andrew Lloyd Webber. You didn't even need to have paid attention to the Mass up to this point. When Kelly sang Pia Jesu, you understood the gravity of Christ's sacrifice in your very heart. For us as musicians, this is our triumph, to sing and to play the truth like this. And Don, you empowered us and guided us and helped us to do it. Just a few weeks ago, all of Villanova united in excitement over the remarkable accomplishment of our basketball team. What you may or may not understand is that that last 4.7 seconds that we all watched while holding our breaths, that's the feeling that pastoral musicians have every time we sing a big piece. Here, as students, and even now, as a music minister out in the real world. That same heart-in-your-throat emotion. The inimitable blending of humility and prowess and leadership and effort and trust and grace. It happens every Sunday, with the reward not of a trophy or a prize or even street cred, but instead the knowledge that you are helping deepen the faith engagement of your peers in the congregation. We are not a club. This is not a performance hall. Under Don's direction, we knew that this is God's house to which his people come to find their way in the world. And we are charged to use music, which is more than words, which speaks to a visceral and yet utterly divine thing inside of us, to convey the truth of God's word to the hearts of his faithful. For me, the moment when this became crystal clear was during the At the Foot of the Cross service in March of 2004. I was standing right there. We were singing Lourdes and Zonata Lux. I was surrounded by people who are, to this day, some of my very dearest friends, whom I love very, very much. Caritas. We were singing many different parts, but all as one, with our eyes on one man, breathing as one, thinking as one, striving to one very specific end. Unitas. O nata lux de lumine Jesu redemptor seculi. O born light of light, Jesus, redeemer of the world. It was absolutely transcendent, and I don't use that term lightly. I remember feeling taken over by something much bigger than myself. It was terrifying, and it was thrilling. Like a gift that I had, that I was offering, was united with the gifts of my friends and together formed something unutterably beautiful and real and true. And as we stood there singing, those golden notes hung in this air. We were bringing to life the story of a spotless maid who gave life to a tiny child who would in turn bring new life to all the world. We were singing to make present the incredible mystery of the incarnation, the very truth, the veritas of our salvation history. Veritas. If it were not for pastoral musicians, and if it were not for Don Giannella, we may never have discovered nor understood why one would possibly name a singing group Veritas.
Thank you. Pastoral Music President for 3 years. For those of you counting at home, that's 15 years ago. We're going backwards in time. Back when we seemed to be a ragtag group of singers and musicians. Caritas, charity, love. I met the love of my life through pastoral musicians. My wife and I were married here on this altar 10 years ago. But this isn't a story about me. Caritas. Let me set the scene for you. It was the late 90s. Tuesday evening. That meant pastoral musicians rehearsal. Don Giannella was particularly punchy. All pastoral musicians know that Don Giannella has levels of punchiness. High, soaringly high, and oh my God, he's out of control. It so happened on this particular Tuesday that maintenance must have been doing some wiring in the church, for there was a giant, thick electrical cable curled up on top of and dangling over Don's piano. And so, as only Don Giannella could do, he hops, and this is pre-inflated whale ankle-shattering incident. 2000? He hops down those three stairs back there and yells, "Hey, kids!" to all the pastoral musicians, and proceeds to connect himself with this electrical cable to the piano. He literally plugs himself into the piano and becomes one with the instrument. Don remained that way from 5:30 until rehearsals end at 7 p.m. Never skipping a beat, fully plugged in, high energy, performing for us, inspiring us, so that we could elevate the hearts, minds, and souls of the Villanova community through the celebration of Mass the following Sunday evening. Villanova has long ago gone wireless. Don is no longer plugged into the piano. But through his career, Don has remained connected to that piano, fostering and enhancing the connections of the Villanova community to its faith through music. He has been our professor of liturgical music, providing the conduit for all of Villanova, enabling voices to call out, rise up, and rejoice. He has been our teacher. Don taught us pastoral musicians the meaning of Latin words and phrases. He taught us to lose our regional accents. It's not ubi caritas. It's ubi caritas. It's not hallelujah. It's hallelujah. He taught us to lift our heads, to project out of our music folders, and to smile when we did so, because we were celebrating the Mass. And without anyone being aware, without anyone being fully cognizant of it, Don taught the entire community of Villanova University to do the same thing. With all due respect to my former professors at here at Villanova, I learned more from this man than I did from any of the courses in which I was enrolled, or texts read, papers written, thesis defended. Don taught me how to love, in the Villanova Caritas sense of loving. He taught me how to love to inform words and deeds in all aspects of life. St. Augustine instructs us to teach in such a way that the person to whom you speak, by hearing, may believe, by believing, hope, and by hoping, love. Don taught us all how to do that. I imagine that's why we're all here on a Saturday night. Not just to celebrate this professor of liturgical music called Don Giannella, but to celebrate that which this Don Giannella teaches us. He teaches us to love. He teaches us true charity. He teaches us caritas. And where there is love, where there is true charity, God is always present.
Thank you. So at this point in the evening, we have a special video message for Don.
Hello, my name is Michael Warren, and this video message comes to you today from Anchorage, Alaska. I was a member of Villanova Pastoral Musicians for my entire time at Villanova University from 1994 to 1998. And I just want to start by thanking you for finding me to be a part of this day of celebration and remembrance. Celebrating and remembering Don Giannella and his influence over our lives, and celebrating and remembering a season of ministry that we all participated in as we were involved with Villanova Pastoral Musicians. In January of 1997, as a junior, my mother died. And needless to say, as a family, we entered into a season of sadness, of grieving, and of brokenness. And I had to leave Villanova and go home for a short season to be with my family. But I will never forget the day that I walked into my home church in New York, the day of my mother's funeral, and walking into my home church. This is the church that I grew up in. This is the church that I attended every single Sunday from the moment I was born until the moment I left for college. Walking into that funeral service that day and hearing one of the most beautiful things I have ever heard in my entire life. My choir, my New York choir, the choir that I had led and directed all through my middle school years, all through my high school years, singing and playing alongside of my friends from Villanova Pastoral Musicians. You see, Don Giannella made a way for pastorals to travel from Villanova, hundreds of miles, all the way up to my home church in New York, and one of the boldest acts of love and kindness that I have ever been on the receiving end of. My family and I remember and rehearse that memory even till today. And here's what I want to say. Without a doubt, I am the man that I am today. I am the husband that I am today. I am the dad that I am today. And I am the friend that I am today because of the mentoring, the coaching, the discipleship, the challenge, the love, and the availability that I experienced knowing Don Giannella in my time with Villanova Pastoral Musicians. Don, I love you for always. Thank you so much for making me a part of this day of remembrance and celebration.
Thank you. students, for all your hard work all year. Thank you, Parish Choir, as always, for your talent and for celebrating with us pastorals tonight. Thank you, alumni, for coming back to honor your experiences here and to share your gifts and passion for pastorals together again. And thank you, of course, to Don Giannella, our directors for the past 21 years, for everything. For the past 21 years, Don sent each of us off on our transitions from college to adult life at the Villanova Baccalaureate Mass and set us free to find our callings. As he prepares to transition from director of the Pastoral Musicians to director of transfer admissions in the College of Arts and Sciences, we have been given this wonderful opportunity to return to Villanova and the Pastoral Musicians to celebrate the community and music that Don created here with all of us. Some of you may know that Don Giannella happens to be my dad. Well, being 22, I've been a witness to the celebration that is Villanova pastoral music my entire conscious life. Watching my dad, the director, do his work. From tagging along to various pastoral events as a shy and embarrassed little kid, to finally getting to be a pastoral musician myself during my time at Villanova. It's hard for me to imagine him leaving something that I've seen bring him and others so much joy my entire life. But as Don's daughter, I've also had a unique vantage point to watch my dad, the teacher, and advisor, grow in his confidence and hone his insight in the classroom. As director of transfer admission, Don will also be the academic advisor for transfer students and will now help students navigate their transitions into the Villanova community. I recently asked my dad how things were going in this new position, since he's already started in a part-time capacity. My dad told me about a recent meeting of advisors in the college, during which advisors were trying to figure out how to talk to students worried about their futures. He said he would ask these students who are worried, "When was the last time you were authentically happy, and what were you doing?" I think we all here would have to say that we are authentically happy in our experiences as pastoral musicians with Don. I don't think we'd all be gathered here tonight if we weren't significantly affected by the unique talent, spirit, and love that Don Giannella brought to this ministry and inspired in all of us. I also think that we pastorals shouldn't be surprised that Don would have the insight to ask students such a question, having had the privilege to receive similar insight and wisdom at all our rehearsals, causing laughter, sometimes tears, or just thoughtful silences every week, in addition to just making music. And I have the statistics to back me up on this one. At this point, I'd like to invite Don up here for a special gift. Please find enclosed your cat's evaluations. Memorialize the experiences of pastoral musicians through the ages in the traditional, though edited for our purposes, format for academic feedback on campus. To illustrate what I've been talking about, Don received the highest marks when asked, "Does the director of this group more often inspire camaraderie and/or religious growth with his tangents than he detracts from group productivity?" And many responses because of his mentorship and friendship beyond just being a musical director. So as we send you to live out your calling to be a teacher, mentor, and friend to your new students at Villanova University, we thank you for this opportunity to return home tonight and for all that you have done these past 21 years. We love you.
Thank you to everyone for everything that was said and sung and for your presence here. I just want to sort of draw something together. In August of 1995, it was my first couple weeks here at Villanova, and it was a day or so before the first orientation mass, the welcome mass, and I was sitting with some pastoral musicians who had come back early, getting used to all this. And I was walking around, and I have to admit, the way Villanova does things, there was all like these balloon arches and kids running around. And I was thinking to myself, does it really need to be this complicated? Everything was a big production, and I wondered whether it needed to be that way. That day, we actually had just finished doing some music for the director of the library, who had passed away suddenly, and in the midst of preparing for orientation, we planned a memorial service for the director. And after that, I was sitting in the spit for lunch, across from a bright-eyed Villanovan with a buzz cut. He's right there. And he was just full of life, and he looked up from whatever he was eating, and out of the blue, he asked me, very seriously, what are your goals for pastoral music? And I felt like I was really new, and I know what I would say now, but then I was still kind of in this sort of behavior motif, but I'm sure my eyebrows answered the question for me. And I didn't really do a sarcastic response, and I don't really know if I gave you an answer, Jay. I don't think I do. And I was still on the same thing. Why does everything at Villanova need to be so complicated? Look, we're here to do music. We have to do, the masses, blah, blah, blah. What other goal could there be? So I didn't answer it, but it was a good thing. Because after two decades of doing it, I couldn't have put it into better words than what we've experienced tonight. And I still don't have the words for it. What we've experienced are my goals for pastoral music at Villanova University, and I hope that we've achieved them with you and will continue to live on in the singing and the spirit of our community. The music we make to support the church's liturgy is the melody of all of our lives, and we brought those melodies together and we made something beautiful tonight with just a little bit of practice. But there's some imprint of what we've been together that really moved us through this experience tonight. And because we're better, the world is better. So whether, I'll go back to my written thing here.
So whether it was corny jokes, melody lines, sermonettes about scripture, song lyric, fragrance of release, how was your break, recruiting new students, there were many, many other things for undergraduates to do. We did trips, we did cheesesteak runs, we had regular practices, we did have big productions. We ultimately were lifted into an experience of beauty. And beauty sweeps you off your feet. And I'm swept off my feet. And I'm really grateful. So in my last 2 weeks here in this job, and I begin my new teaching, hopefully making a difference, I'm going to answer Jimmy D's question from August 1995. Finally got around to it. This is my goal at Pastoral Music, and rather than being silent about it, I now have two words which I didn't have then. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. My two words, my goals. Thank you for coming. Let's sing and close this out together.